I want you to tell us, who is this kid after you spent some time with him, and what is he going to become?
Let's remember, he is a kid.
He is.
He has 2 years of eligibility left at Texas A&M. So he's not a finished product. He's not 23 mm-hmm. years old. He's not a fifth-year senior. He's a kid. He's made some mistakes that a lot of kids have made. I don't even know if they're dramatic mistakes, by the way. He's a kid, mm-hmm. but he is an exciting college football player. If he gets in the right environment and can get a coach that believes in him, that can stay with his offense for the next 3 or 4 years, Manziel will be a smash hit. I really believe
smash it. Hit. He's as got, in star.
I believe so.
He's as got, in he's could got make a, Pro Bowls.
I believe he can.
I think he can.
I think he can create offense unlike most guys I've ever seen. And he has guts, quickness, vision, and he loves the big arena. He loves the big stage. Guys like him don't come across the map very often.
Okay, so how can the Houston Texans afford not to take a kid from just up the road in College Station, Texas?
I don't know, unless you want to play with Case Keenum and Ryan Fitzpatrick.
Well, I guess that's what they want to do.
Well, I just think if you're an offensive coach like Bill O'Brien, I can only imagine the thoughts that he's entertaining. There's not a play that Manziel can't run. You want to run read options, speed options, no huddle. You want to move the pocket, stay in the pocket. I've seen him do it. He's not a finished product. It might not happen right away, but this kid's going to go places if he finds somebody that gives him the opportunity.
Okay, you know of Bill O'Brien. I don't know if you know him personally. Have you been around him?
I don't know him great, but I have met him several times.
You can make a case that this kid is not his cup of quarterback tea. He's obviously Coach Brady, and then he had Christian Hackenberg, who's, 6'5", 235, classic prototypical dropback passer, pocket passer. It's possible that Bill would finally say, you know what, I just don't want to rebuild this program offensively around this kid. I respect him, but he's not my kind of guy. So if you're calling the shots, if you're the GM or the owner, what are you going to do? Because this is a first-year head coach. Again, he's coached Penn State, but he hadn't coached the Houston Texans in the National Football League. Which way would you lean on this one?
Well, I was head coach for 11 years, and I was waiting for Andrew Luck to knock on my door and walk in and be our starting quarterback, too. Yeah. He's my kind of guy.
Okay.
Peyton Manning was my kind of guy. Unfortunately, the Colts took him, and Charles Woodson was our pick. My point is, where are you going to get a quarterback, and when are you going to start this developmental process? Are you going to wait till a year from now and hope Jameis Winston is available when you pick? Are you going to wait and see if Hundley's the answer at UCLA? And who's to say you're going to be on the clock when they're available? You better find somebody at this position that has the ability and has the upside and the brains that you can develop and bring along. That's your job. That's why you're in this position. I think every team covets a quarterback, and this is the pool of players that we have this year.
Okay, so you have Manziel ranked in your book far ahead of these other kids, right?
I have Johnny up there because of his production and how quickly he's produced in the highest level of college football. All you got to do is get to 2 Alabama games. Watch this kid perform against the best defense, I believe, in college football. I realize he struggled late against LSU and Missouri, but he had some injury problems. I realize he's got some durability issues, but he can learn. He wants to learn. And, man, is he fun to be around.
He
just brings your organization up, I think, a notch.
Did you feel, and I know him a little bit myself, I think this kid has a high IQ on and off the football field. Did you get chalkboard IQ from him?
We had 2 days of chalkboard.
Yep.
And he has very good communication skills, very good retention. And when he learns it, he can teach it. And that's what the quarterbacks of today have to do with this new CBA. These quarterbacks have to be able to get on their phone and call these players and get them to Texas, get them to California, and run these workouts because they're not available anymore like mm-hmm. they used to be. So there's a huge upside here. It's not a finished product. It might take a year. It might take 6 months. But it's going to happen, and I think it's well worth rolling the dice.
Okay, but we have our Mel Kiper, who sat here as late as yesterday and said, hey, Jadeveon Clowney is once in 20 years as a pass rusher. Todd McShay says he's never graded a better pass rusher, a more dominating pass rusher than Clowney. You had, once upon a time, Simeon Rice flying off that edge for you. You had a whole lot of other football players, too. You had Sapp and the whole red, Derek Brooks, obviously, and it was an all-time great defense, but you did have a stud pass rusher. So would that give you how much pause if you're with that first pick?
Well, hey, I want Clowney, too. You can't have everything in this world, Skip.
No.
Now you got one pick.
I'm with
but
you.
I remember working for Al Davis, and you used to cover the Raiders out there. Mm-hmm. I can still remember, oh, God, there's Skip Bayless.
Uh-oh.
Because he was after me out there. Yeah. But I can remember Al Davis saying, what's the priority of this organization? What position? It's the quarterback. It was in Al's wheelhouse. It was in my wheelhouse. It was the same thing in Green Bay with Ron Wolf when we made the Favre trade. When I grew up with the 49ers, it was Montana, and they traded for Steve Young. You better have a quarterback, mm-hmm. and you better start developing one, or the chances are you'll be like me, fired.
There you go. Okay, let's do bigger picture. If you could handpick an offensive coach for Johnny Manziel, I'm going to just throw a name out there for you. If I could do this, I would pick Chip Kelly. And I'm not going to rule out Chip Kelly and company making a run at trying to land Johnny Manziel in this draft before it's all said and done. That would be my best fit for him. Where would be best? Because sometimes it's a matter of fit, as you well know, on how the kid's going to progress.
Well, you're talking to a Gruden here, so I'm going to go with Jaden.
Okay, all right, that's good. All right.
I like Sean Payton. I like Andy Reid. Those are the coaches that I grew up with. Mark Trestman. People that have a huge, I think, amount of imagination. It's not about what this quarterback can do in my offense. It's about putting an offense together that really accentuates this kid's strengths. This is our quarterback. We're going to have to cater everything towards him, and we'll try to give him as much as he can handle. The great thing about Russell Wilson is you can call any play you can dream up, Skip, and I think Manziel has some of these qualities. Option football, drop back football, no back sets, up tempo. I think he has a lot of the similar traits I'm looking for.